I've heard people saying that Adam is Satan. I've read the lost books of the Bible, and I've said this several times here on YouTube and other places. There's just no way he was, because he had a repentant heart. I've read the book of Adam and Eve, and I want to read it to you so you can see that that's not true. There's just no way he was Satan. He loved God with all his heart. He conversed with him every day, because he could see up in heaven. And God walked with him in the cool of the day. After they were kicked out of the Garden of Eden, he continued to converse with him. So let me begin to read this. Chapter 1. The Crystal Sea. God commands Adam, expelled from Eden, to dwell in the Cave of Treasures. And on the third day, God planted the garden in the east of the earth, on the border of the world, eastward, beyond which, towards the sun rising, one finds nothing but water, what encompasses the whole world and reaches into the borders of heaven. And to the north of the garden, there is a sea of water, clear and pure to taste, like unto nothing else, so that through the clearness thereof, one may look into the depths of the earth, and when a man washes himself in it, becomes clean of the cleanliness thereof, and a white of its whiteness, even if he were dark. And God created that sea of his own good pleasure. He knew what would come of him, what would come of the man he should make. So that after he had left the garden, on account of his transgressions, he would be born in the earth, from among whom righteousness ones should die, whose souls God would rise at the last day. Now, as I read this, you will see that it has references all through the Bible, as right there, saying that he would rise us up on the last day. When we should return to our flesh, should bathe in the water of that sea, and all of them repent of their sins. So he's talking about repentant, being having a repentant heart and being baptized in the water. But when God made Adam out of the garden, he did not place him on the border of the northward, lest he would draw near to the sea of the water, and he and Eve would wash themselves in it, be cleansed of their sins, forgotten of the transgression that they would commit, and be no longer reminded of it in the thought of their punishment. Then again, as the southward side of the garden, God was so pleased to let Adam dwell there, because when the wind blew from the north, it would bring him on the southern side of the delicious smell of the trees of the garden. Therefore, God did not put Adam there, lest he would smell the sweet smell of those trees, forget his transgression, and find consolation of what he had done. Take delight of the smell of the trees, and not be cleansed of his transgression. Again, also, because God is merciful and of a great pity, and governs all things in the way he alone knows, he made our father Adam dwell in the western border of the garden, because on that side of the earth is very broad. And God commanded him to dwell there in a cave, in a rock, in the Cave of Treasures below the garden. Chapter 2. And Adam and Eve faint upon leaving the garden. God sends his word to encourage them. But when our father Adam and Eve went out of the garden, they trod the ground on their feet, not knowing they were treading. And when they came to the opening of the gate of the garden and saw the broad earth spread before them, covered with stones large and small, and with sand, they feared and trembled and fell on their face from the fear that came upon them, and they were as dead. Because, whereas they had within been in the garden land, beautiful, planted with all manners of trees, they now saw themselves in a strange land which they knew not and had never seen. And because all at the time they were filled with the grace of a bright nature, and they had not hearts turned toward earthly things, therefore had God pity upon them. And when he saw them fallen before the gate of the garden, he sent his word unto the father Adam and Eve and raise them from their fallen state. Concerning the promise of the great 5 days and a half, chapter 3. God said to Adam, I have ordained on this earth days and years, and thou and thy seed shall dwell and walk on it until the days and the years fulfilled. And then I shall send the word that created thee, and against which thou hast transgressed, and the word that made thee come out of the garden, and that raised thee when thou wast fallen. Yea, the word that will again save thee when the 5 days and a half are fulfilled. But when Adam heard these words from God and of the great 5 days and a half, he did not understand the meaning of them. And Adam was thinking that there would be 5 days and a half for him and the end of the world. And Adam wept and prayed God to explain them to him. And then God, in his mercy for Adam, who had was made after his own image and similitude, explained to him that these were 5,500 years, and how one would then come and save him and his seed. But God had before that made his covenant with our father Adam in the same terms ere he came out of the garden. And when he was by the tree there of Eve, took the fruit and gave him to eat. Inasmuch as our father Adam came out of the garden, he passed by the tree and saw how God had them changed in the appearance of it into another form, and how it withered. And as Adam went to it, he feared and trembled and fell down. But God in his mercy lifted him up, and then made this covenant with him. And again, when Adam was by the gate of the garden, saw the cherub with the sword, a flashing fire in his hand, and the cherub grew angry and frowned at him. Both Adam and Eve became afraid of him, and thought he meant to put them to death. So they fell on their faces and trembled with fear. But he had pity on them and showed them mercy, and turned from them and went up to heaven and prayed with Yahweh and said, Lord, thou doest send me to watch the gate of the garden with a sword of fire. But when thy servants Adam and Eve saw me, they fell on their face and were dead. And my Lord, what shall we do with our servants? And then God had pity upon them and showed them mercy and sent his angel to watch the garden. And the word of Yahweh came upon Adam and Eve and raised them up. And Yahweh said to Adam, I told you that the end of the 5 days and a half I will send my word and save thee. Strengthen thy heart, therefore, and abide in the cave of treasures of which I have spoken unto thee. And when Adam heard this word from God, he was comforted in that which the Lord had told him, for he had told him how he would save him. Chapter 4. Adam laments and changed condition, and Adam and Eve entered into the cave of treasures. But Adam and Eve wept for having come out of the garden, their first abode. And indeed, when Adam looked at his flesh and was altered, he wept bitterly. He and Eve, over what they had done, they walked and went gently down into the cave of treasures. And as they came into it, Adam wept over himself and said to Eve, Look at this cave, that it is to be our prison in this world, a place of punishment. What is it compared to the garden? What is this narrowness compared to the space of the other? What is this rock by the side of these groves? What is the gloom of the cave compared to the light of the garden? What is this overhanging ledge of rock to shelter us compared to the mercy of Yahweh that is overshadowing us? What is the soil of this cave compared to the garden land? This earth showed with stones, and that planted with delicious fruit trees. And Adam and Eve looked at in thine eyes, and at that which afar beheld angels with heaven praising, and they too, without ceasing. But now we do not see them as we did. Our eyes have become flesh, and they cannot see in like manner as they saw before. And Adam said to Eve, "What is our body today compared to what it was in the former days when we dwelt in the garden?" And after this, Adam did not like to enter the cave under the overhanging rock, nor did he ever have entered it. But he bowed to God's orders and said to him, "Unless I enter the cave, I shall again be a transgressor." Chapter 5, in which Eve makes a noble intercession, taking blame all on herself. When Adam and Eve entered the cave and stood praying in their own tongue, unknown to us, by which they knew well, as they prayed, Adam raised his eyes and saw the rock in the roof of the cave and covered him overhead, so that he could see neither heaven nor God's creatures. So he wept and smote heavenly upon his breast until he dropped and was dead. And even Eve sat weeping, for she believed that he was dead. And as she rose and stepped her hands and spread her hands toward God, saying to him, "Mercy and pity," and said, "O God, forgive me for my sin, the sin which I committed, and remember it not against me. For I alone caused my servant to fall from the garden into this lost estate, from the light into this darkness, and from above, for the joy, into this prison. O God, look upon this, thy servant, who has fallen, and raised him into his death, that he may weep and repent for his transgression which he committed through me. Take not his soul this place, but let him live, that he may stand before the treasures of his repentance and do thy will before his death. But if thou do not raise him up, then, O God, take my soul, that I be like him, and leave not me in this dungeon, one and alone, for I could not stand alone in this world with him only. For thou, O God, didst cause a slumber to come upon him in a mist, and take a bone from him side, and dost restore the flesh into the place of it by thy divine power. And thou dost take me a bone, and make me a woman, bright like him, with a heart, and reason in speech, and in flesh, and like unto his own. And thou dost make me after and likeness in his countenance, and thy mercy and thy power. O Lord, I and he are one, and thou, O God, are our creator. And thou, he who made me both in one day, therefore, O God, give him life, that he may be with me on this strange land, while we dwell in it, in account of our transgression. If thou wilt not give me him and his life, then take me, even me like him, that we both may die in the same day. And Eve wept bitterly and fell upon her father Adam for her great sorrow. Chapter 6. God looked upon them, for they had killed themselves through great grief, but he would raise them and comfort them. He therefore set his word unto them, and they should stand and be raised forthwith. And Yahweh said unto Adam and Eve, "Your transgressions of your own free will, until you come out of the garden which I had placed you, of your own free will you transgressed, and through your desire of divinity and greatness and exalted states, which I have, so I have deprived you of the bright nature in which you then were. And I made you come out of the garden into this land, rough and full of trouble. And if you had not transgressed my commandment, and have kept my law, and not eaten of the fruit of the tree, near which I told you not to come, and there were fruit trees in the garden better than that one." But the wicked Satan, who continued not in his first state, nor kept his faith, and whom was good intended towards me, who thought I had created him, yet set me at naught, and sought the Godhead, so that I hurled him down from heaven. He is who made the tree appear pleasant in your eyes until you ate it, by hearkening unto him. Thus you have transgressed my commandment, and therefore have I brought upon you all these sorrows. For I am God the Creator, who, when I created my creatures, did not intend to destroy them. But after they had sorely roused my anger, I punished them with my grievous plagues until they repent. But if, on contrary, they still continue hardened in their transgressions, they shall be under a curse forever. And when Adam and Eve hardened their words from God, they wept and sobbed yet more. They strengthened their hearts in God, because they now felt that Yahweh was to them like a father and a mother. And for this, their very reason, they wept before him and sought mercy from them. And God had pity on them and said, O Adam, I have made my covenant with thee. I will not turn from it, neither will I let thee return to the garden until my covenant of the great 5 years and a half be fulfilled. Adam said to God, O Lord, thou doest create us and make us fit to be in the garden. And before I transgress, thou madest all beasts come to me, that I should name them. Thy grace was then on me, and I named every one according to thy mind, and thou madest them all subject unto me. But now, O God, I have transgressed and thy commandment. All the beasts will rise against me, and will devour me and Eve, thou handmaiden, and will cut off our life from the face of the earth. I therefore beseech thee, O God, that since thou hast made us come out of the garden, and hast made us in this strange land, thou wilt not let the beast hurt us. And then Yahweh heard these words from Adam. He had pity on him, and felt that he had truly said that the beast of the field will rise and devour him and Eve, because he, Yahweh, was angry with them, too, on account of their transgressions. And then God commanded the beast and the birds and all that move upon the earth to come to Adam and be familiar with him, and not to trouble him and Eve, nor let any of the good and right of their prosperity. And then the beast did obedience unto Adam according to the commandment of God, and except the serpent, against which God was wroth. It did not come to Adam with the beast. Chapter 8. And then Adam wept and said, O God, when we dwelt in the garden, our hearts was lifted up, and we saw the angels that sing praise in the heaven. But now we do not see them where we used to. Nay, when we enter into the cave, all creation became hidden from us. And then God, Yahweh, said unto Adam, when thou wast under subjection to me, thou hadst a bright nature within thee, and for the reason couldst thou see things far off. But after thy transgression, thy bright nature was withdrawn from thee, and it was not left to thee to see things afar off, but only near at hand, after the ability of the flesh, for it is brutish. And then Adam and Eve had heard these words from the God, they went their way, praising and worshiping God with a sorrowful heart. And God cleansed, and God ceased to commune with them. Chapter 9. And Adam and Eve came out of the cave of treasures and drew near to the garden gate. And they stood and looked in it and wept for having come from it. And Adam and Eve went before the gate of the garden of the southern side of it, and found there the water that watered the garden from the roof of the tree of life, that parted them from hence to the four rivers of the earth. And then they came and drew near to the water and looked for it, and saw that it was the water that came forth from under the root of the tree of life in the garden. And Adam wept and wailed and smote upon his breast for being severed from the garden, and said to Eve, why hast thou brought upon me upon myself and upon this seed. So many of these plagues and punishments. And Eve said unto him, What is it that thou hast seen, to weep and speak unto me like this? And he said unto Eve, Seest thou not this water that has with us in the garden, that these are the trees of the garden and that flowed out there? And we, when we are in the garden, did not care about it. But since we came into this strange land, we love it and turn to it for use of our body. And then Eve heard these words from him. She wept. And from the soreness of their weeping, they fell into that water and would have put an end to themselves in it, so as to never again to return and behold the creation that they looked upon, the work of the creation that they felt they must put an end to themselves. 10. And then God, merciful and gracious, looked upon them lying in the water and nigh unto death, and sent an angel who brought them out of the water and laid them upon the shore as dead. And then the angel went up to God as welcome and said, O God, thy creatures have breathed their last breath. And God sent his word upon Adam and Eve, who raised them from their dead. And Adam said after he was raised, O God, while we were in the garden, we did not require or care for this water. Since we came to this land, we cannot do without it. And then God said to Adam, While thou wast under my command, and was a bright angel, who knowest not this water, but after thou hast transgressed my commandment, thou hast not, does not without water, wherein to wash thy body and to take, to make it grow. For it is not like that of the beasts. It is not, and is in want of water. And then Adam and Eve heard these words from God. They wept a bitter cry. And Adam entrusted God to let him return to the garden and to look at it the second time. And God said to Adam, I have made thee a promise. And when the promise is fulfilled, I will bring thee back into the garden, thee and my righteous seed. And God ceased to commune with Adam. 11. And then Adam and Eve felt themselves burning for thirst, heat, and sorrow. And Adam said to Eve, We shall not drink this water, even if we were to die. O Eve, when the water comes into the inner parts, it will increase our punishment and that of our children that shall come after us. And both Adam and Eve then withdrew from the water and drank none of it at all, but came and entered into the cave of treasures. But when in it Adam could not see Eve, he only heard the noise she made. Neither could she see Adam, but heard the noise he made. And then Adam wept into a deep affliction and smote upon his breast. And he arose and said, Where art thou? And she said to him, Lo, I am standing in this darkness. He then said to her, Remember the bright nature in which we lived while we were abode in the garden. And O Eve, remember the glory that rested on us in the garden. O Eve, remember the trees that overshadowed us in the garden while we moved among them. O Eve, remember what while we were in the garden, we knew neither night or day. O the tree of life from below, which flowed with water and that shed luster over us. Remember, O Eve, the garden and the brightness thereof. Think, O think of that garden which was no darkness while we dwelt there, where no sooner did we come into this cave of treasures than darkness encompassed us around about until we came no longer see each other, and all the pleasure of this life has come to an end. 12. And then Adam smote upon his breast, he and Eve, and they mourned the whole night until dawn drew near, and they sought over the length of the night in M-I-Y-A-Z-I-A. I have no idea how to pronounce that word. And Adam beat himself and threw himself on the ground in the cave from bitter grief, and became of darkness and lay there as dead. But Eve heard the noise he made in the falling upon the earth, and she felt about for him with her hands and found him like a corpse. And she was afraid and speechless and remained by him. But the mercy of Yahweh looked upon the death of Adam and upon Eve's silence from the fear of the darkness. And the word of God came upon Adam and raised him from his dead and opened Eve's mouth that she might speak. And Adam arose from the cave and said, O God, wherefore has light departed from us and the darkness came over us? Therefore dost thou leave us in this long darkness. Why wilt thou plague us this darkness, O Lord? There was an error to come upon us, and such that we cannot see each other. For so long we were in the garden, we neither saw nor even knew what darkness was. I was not hidden from Eve, neither she was hidden from me, until now that she cannot see me. And no darkness came upon us to separate us from each other, but she and I were both in one bright light, and I saw her as she saw me. Yet now, since we come into this cave, darkness has come upon us and parted us asunder, so that I do not see her and she does not see me. O Lord, wilt thou then plague us with this darkness? Chapter 13. And when God, who is merciful and full of pity, heard Adam's voice, he said unto him, O Adam, so long as a good angel was obedient to me, a bright light rested upon him, and his host. But when he transgressed my commandment, I deprived him of that bright nature, and he became dark. And when he was in the heavens in the realm of light, he knew not of darkness. But he transgressed, and I made him fall from heaven upon the earth, and it was darkness that came upon him. And on thee, O Adam, while in my garden, the obedience to me was a bright light, rest also. But when I heard of thy transgression, I deprived thee of that bright light. Yet of my mercy I do not turn thee into darkness, but I made thee thy body of flesh, over which I spread this skin, in order that it may bear cold heat. If I had let my wrath fall heavenly upon thee, I should have destroyed thee. And if I had turned thee into darkness, it would have been as if I killed thee. But in my mercy, I have made thee as thou art. And when thou dost transgress my commandment, O Adam, I have drove thee from the garden, and made thee come forth into this land, and command thee to dwell in this cave. And darkness came upon thee, as I did upon him who transgressed my commandment. Thus, O Adam, has this night deceived thee? It is not the last forever, but is only for 12 hours. When it is over, daylight will return. Sigh not, therefore neither be moved, and say not in thy heart that this darkness is long and drags on wearily. And say not in thy heart that I plague thee with it. Strengthen thy heart and be not afraid. This darkness is not a punishment. But, O Adam, I have made the day and have placed the sun in it to give light, in order that thou and thy children shall do your work. For I knew that thou shouldst sin and transgress and come out unto this land. Yet would I not force thee, nor be heard upon thee, nor shut up, nor doom thee, though thou fall, nor thought thou coming out from light into darkness, nor yet through thy coming from the garden into this land. For I made thee as a light, and I will bring out your children to light from thee, like unto thee. But thou doest not keep one day of my commandment, until I finish the creation and bless everything in it. And when I command thee concerning the tree, that thou eat not thereof. Yet I knew that Satan, who deceived himself, would also deceive thee. So I made known to thee by thy means of the tree, not to come near him. And I told thee not to eat of the fruit thereof, nor to taste of it, nor to sit under the tree, nor yield of it. Had I not been spoken of thee, O Adam, concerning the tree, and I left thee without a commandment, and thou hast sinned, it would have been an offense of my part. Nor having given thee any order, thou wouldest turned around and blame me for it. But I commanded thee and warned thee that thou didst fall. So my creatures cannot blame me, but blame the rest on them alone. And, O Adam, I have made the day of thee for my children after thee, for them to work and toil within. And I've made the night for them to rest in it from their work, and for the beasts of the field to go forth by the night to seek their food. But little of the darkness now remains, O Adam. The daylight will soon appear. Chapter 12. Then Adam said unto God, O Lord, take thy soul, and let me not see this gloom any more, or remove me from some place where there is no darkness. And God Yahweh said unto Adam, Verily I said unto thee, this darkness will pass from thee every day, and the fulfillment of my covenant, when I will save thee and bring thee back again into the garden, unto the abode of light, thou longest for. Therein is no darkness, and I will bring thee unto the kingdom of heaven. And again God said unto Adam, All this mystery that thou hast been made to take upon thee because of thou transgression will not flee from the hand of Satan, and will not save thee, but I will. And when I shall come down from heaven, and shall become flesh unto thy seed, and take upon me the infirmity of which thou sufferest, when the darkness that came upon thee in this cave shall come upon me in the grave, when I am the flesh of thy seed, and I who am without years shall be subject unto the reckoning of the years of times of months and of days, and I shall be reckoned as one of the sons of men in order to save thee. So this is Yesu talking to him. And God ceased to come unto Adam. Chapter 15. And Adam and Eve wept and sorrowed by reason of God's word to them, and they should not return to the garden until the fulfillment of the days decreed upon them, but mostly because Yahweh told them that Yesu would suffer for their salvation. Chapter 16. And after this, Adam and Eve ceased not to stand in the cave, praying and weeping until morning dawned upon them. And when they saw the light return to them, they restrained from fear and strengthened their hearts. And Adam began to come out of the cave. And when he came to the mouth of it, and stood and turned his face towards the east, and saw the sun rise up in the glowing rays, and felt the heat thereof on his body, he was afraid of it, and thought in his heart that the flame came forth to plague him. And he wept then, and smote upon his breast, and fell upon the earth on his face, and made request, saying, O Lord, plague me not, neither consume me, nor let take away my life from the earth. And he thought the sun was Yahweh. Inasmuch as while he was upon the garden, and heard the voice of Yahweh and the sound he made in the garden, and feared him, Adam never saw the brilliant light of the sun, neither did the flaming heat thereof touch his body. Therefore was he afraid of the sun when flaming rays of it reached him. He thought Yahweh meant to plague him, wherewith all the days he had decreed for him. For Adam also said to his thoughts, As God did not plague us with the darkness, behold, he has ceased this sun to rise and to plague us with burning heat. But while he was thus thinking this in his heart, the word of Yahweh came to him and said, O Adam, arise and stand up. This sun is not Yahweh, has been created to give light by day, of which I spoke to thee in the cave, saying that the dawn would break forth, and there would be light by day. But I am Yahweh, who comforted thee in the night. And God ceased to commune with Adam. Chapter 17. And then Adam and Eve came out of the mouth of the cave and went towards the garden. But as they drew near unto it before the western gate, from which Satan came when he deceived Adam and Eve, they found the serpent that became Satan coming at the gate, and sorrowfully licking the dust and wiggling on its breast on the ground, by reason of the curse that fell upon it from Yahweh. And whereas aforetime the serpent was the most excellent of all beasts, now it was changed and become slippery and the meanest of them all, and it crept on its breast and went along on its belly. And therefore, as it was the fairest of all the beasts, it had been changed and has become the ugliest of them all. Instead of feeding on the best food, now it turned to eat the dust. Instead of dwelling, as before, in the best places, now it lived in the dust. And therefore it had been the most beautiful of all of the beasts, all of which stood dumbed at its beauty. It was now abhorred by them. And again, whereas it dwelt in one beautiful abode, to which all other animals came from elsewhere, and where it drank, they drank also of some. Now after it had become venomous, by the reason of Yahweh's curse, all beasts fled from its abode, and would not drink of the water it drank, but fled from it. Chapter 18. And when the accused serpent saw Adam and Eve, it swelled in its head and stood on its tail, and with its eyes blood red, did as if it would kill them. It made straight for Eve and ran after her, while Adam, standing up, wept because he had no stick in his hand wherewith to smite the serpent, and knew not how to put it to death. But with a heart burning for Eve, Adam approached the serpent and held it by the tail. And when it turned towards him and said to him, O Adam, because of thee and of Eve, I am slippery and upon my belly. And then by reason of its great strength, it threw down Adam and Eve and pressed upon them as if it would kill them. But Yahweh sent an angel to throw the serpent away from them and arise them up. Then the word of Yahweh came into the serpent and said to it, In the first instance I made thee glib and made thee go up on thy belly, but I did not derive thee of speech. And now, however, be thou dumb and speak no more, thou and thy race, because in the first place was the ruin of my creatures happened because of thee and thy wiseness to kill them. And then the serpent was struck dumb and spake no more. And the wind came and blew from heaven by the command of Yahweh, that carried away the serpent from Adam and Eve, and threw it into the seashore, and it landed in India. Chapter 19. But Adam and Eve wept before Yahweh, and God said unto him, O Lord, when I was in the cave, I said this to thee, my Lord, that the beast of the field would rise and devour me, and cut off my life from the earth. And then Adam, by reason of that, had befell him, and smote upon his breast, and fell down upon the earth like a corpse. And then came to him the word of God, who raised him and said to him, O Adam, not one of these beasts will be able to hurt thee, because when I made the beast and all other living things come to thee in the cave, I did not let the serpent come into thee, lest I shall raise up against you and make you tremble, and the fear of it would fall into your hearts. For I know that the accused one is wicked, therefore I not let it come near you with all the other beasts. But now strengthen thy heart and fear not, for I am with thee unto the end of the days. I have determined unto thee. Chapter 20. And then Adam wept and said, O God, remove us to some other place, that the serpent may not come near us and rise up against us, lest it find my handmaiden Eve alone and kill her, for its eyes are hideous and evil. But God said unto Adam and to Eve, henceforth fear not, I will not let it come near you. I have driven it away from you from this mountain, neither will I leave in it aught to hurt you. Then Adam and Eve worshipped before God, and gave him thanks, and praised him, and having delivered them from death. Chapter 21. And then Adam and Eve went in search of the garden, and the heat beat like a flame on their face, and they sweated from the heat and wept before Yahweh. But the place where they wept, and high into a high mountain facing the western gate of the garden. And then Adam threw himself down on the top of that mountain, and his face was torn, and his flesh was frayed. Much blood flowed from him, and he was nigh unto death. Meanwhile, Eve remained standing on the mountain, weeping over him thus lying, and she said, I wish not to live after him, for all that he did for himself was through me. And she threw herself after him, and was torn and scratched with stones, and remained lying as dead. But the merciful God, who looks upon his creatures, looked upon Adam and Eve as they lay dead, and he sent his word unto them, and raised them up, and said unto Adam, O Adam, all of this misery which thou hast brought upon yourself will not avail against my rule, neither will it alter the covenant of the 5,500 years. Chapter 22. Then Adam said unto Yahweh, I wither in the heat, I am faint from walking, and I am loath of this world, and I know not when thou wilt bring me out of it to rest. And then Yahweh God said unto him, O Adam, it cannot be at present, not until thou hast ended thy days. Then shall I bring thee out of this wretched land. And Adam said unto God, while I was in the garden, I knew neither heat nor languor, neither moving about, nor trembling, nor fear. But now, since I came into this land, all this affliction has come upon me. And then Yahweh said unto Adam, so long as thou wast keeping my commandment, my light and my grace rested on thee. But when thou hast transgressed my commandment, sorrow and misery befell thee on this land. And Adam wept and said, O Lord, do not cut me off for this, neither smite me with heavy plagues, nor yet repay me according to my sin. For me, my own will transgress my commandment, for forsook my law, and sought to become gods like thee, when Satan the enemy deceived us. And then God said again unto Adam, because thou hast bore fear and trembling in this land, languor and suffering, treading and walking about, going up on this mountain and dying from it, I will take all this unto myself in order to save thee. Chapter 23. And then Adam wept more and said, O God, have mercy upon me, so far as to take upon thee that which I do. But God took his word from Adam and Eve. And then Adam and Eve stood on their feet. And Adam said to Eve, gird yourself, and I will gird myself. And she girded herself and told her. And then Adam and Eve took stones and placed them in the shape of an altar. And they took leaves from the trees outside the garden, which they wiped from the face of the rock the blood they had spilled, but that which dripped on the sand they took together in the dust wherein it was mingled, and offered it up to the altar in an offering unto God. Then Adam and Eve stood under the altar and wept, thus entreating God, forgive us of our trespasses. This was original for the Lord's Prayer, said to be used about 150 years before the Lord. Our Father, thou art in heaven, be gracious unto us. O Lord, our God, hallowed be thy name, and let the remembrance of thee be glorified in heaven above the earth. Here below, let thy kingdom reign over us now, forever. The holy men of old said, remit and forgive unto all men whosoever they have done unto me. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil thing. For thine is the kingdom, and thou shalt reign in glory forever and ever. Amen. And our sins, and look upon us with thine eyes for mercy. And then we, when we were in the garden, our praises and our hymns went up before thee without ceasing. But when we came into this strange land, pure praises were no longer ours, and our righteous prayers and our understanding heart, our sweet thoughts or just counsels, nor long discernments, nor upright feelings, neither is our bright nature left us. But our body is changed from the solitude in which it was first when we were created. Yet now look upon our bodies which is offered upon these stones, and accept it as our hands, like the praises we used to sing unto thee at first when we were in the garden. And Adam began to make more request unto Yahweh. Chapter 24. And then the merciful Yahweh, good and loving of men, looked upon Adam and Eve, and upon their blood, which they had held up as an offering unto him, without an order for him or for so doing, but he wondered at them and accepted their offerings. And Yahweh sent from his presence a bright fire that consumed their offering, and he smelled the sweet savor of their offering and showed them mercy. And then came the word of God. Adam said unto him, O Adam, as thou has sent thy blood, so I will send my blood when I become flesh of my seed, as thou must die. O Adam, so also will I die. And as thou doest, and as thou didst build an altar, so also will I make thee an altar on the earth. And as thou didst offer thy blood upon it, so also will I offer my blood upon the altar of the earth. And Jesus is saying, I will be a blood offering too. And as thou didst sue for forgiveness throughout that blood, so will I make my blood forgiveness of sins and blot out the transgressings in it. And now behold, I have accepted thy offering, O Adam, but the days of the covenant wherein I have bond with thee are not fulfilled. And when they are fulfilled, I will bring thee back into the garden. Now therefore strengthen thy heart, and when sorrow comes upon thee, make me an offering, and I will be favorable of thee. Chapter 25. But God knew that Adam had in his thoughts that he should often kill himself and make an offering to him of his blood. Therefore did he ask him, O Adam, do not again kill yourself as thou didst, by throwing thyself down from the mountain. But Adam said unto God, it was in my mind to put an end to myself at once, for having transgressed thy commandments, and for my having come out of the beautiful garden, and for the bright light of which thou deprivest me, and of the praises which poureth forth from my mouth without cleansing, and for the light that covereth me. Yet thou goodness, O Yahweh, do not away with me altogether, but be favorable to me every time I die and bring me to life. And thereby it will be made known that thou art a merciful God, who willest not that one should perish, who lovest thou that one should fall, and who doest not commend any one cruelty badly by whole destruction. And Adam remained silent, and the word of Yahweh came unto him, and blessed him, and comforted him, and the covenant within him, and he should save him at the end of the days determined upon him. This then was the first offering Adam made unto Yahweh, and so it became his customs to do. Chapter 26. And then Adam took Eve, and they began to return to the cave of treasures where they dwelt. And when they learned, and when they neared it, and saw it from the altar, heavy sorrow fell upon Adam and Eve when they looked at it. And then Adam said to Eve, when we were in the mountain, we were comforted by the word of Yahweh that conversed with us, and the light that came from the east shone over us. But now the word of Yahweh is hidden from us, and the light is shone over us is so changed as it disappeared. And let the darkness and sorrow come upon us, and we are forced to enter this cave. It's like a prison wherein darkness covers us, so that we are parted from each other, and thus can't see me, neither can I see thee. Then Adam had said these words, they wept and spread their hands before God, and they were filled with sorrow. And they entered Yahweh to bring the sun to them and shine upon them, so that the darkness returned not upon them, and they came not again under this covering of the rock. And they wished to die rather than to see the darkness. And then God looked upon Adam and Eve, and upon their great sorrow, and upon all they had done with the fervent heat, on account of all the trouble they were in instead of their former well-being, and on the account of all the misery that came upon them in the strange land. And therefore God was not wroth with them, nor patient with them, but he was long-suffering and forbearing toward them as towards the children he had created. And then came the word of Yahweh to Adam and said to him, Adam, as for the sun, if I were to take it and bring it to thee, days and hours and years and months, it would come to naught, and the covenant I have made with thee would never be fulfilled. But thou shouldest then be turned and left in a long plague, and no salvation would be left to thee forever. Yet rather bear long and calm thy soul while thou abidest night and day, until the fulfillment of the days and the time of my covenant is come. Then shall I come and save thee, O Adam, for I do not wish thou to be afflicted. And then I look at all the good things in which thou doest live, and thou thus comest out of them, and when I willingly show thee mercy, but I can't alter the covenant that has gone out of my mouth, else I would have brought thee back into the garden. Then however the covenant is fulfilled, then shall I show thee thy seed mercy, and bring thee into the land gladness, where there is neither sorrow nor suffering, but abideth joy and gladness and light that never fails, and praise that never ceases, and a beautiful garden that shall never pass away. And Yahweh said again unto Adam, be long-suffering, and enter into the cave, for the darkness which thou was afraid shall be 12 hours long, and when ended, light shall also arise. And then when Adam heard these words from Yahweh, he and Eve worshipped before God, before him, and their hearts were comforted. They returned into the cave after their custom, while tears flowed from their eyes, sorrow and wailing came from their hearts, and they wished their soul would leave their body. And Adam and Eve stood praying until the darkness of the night came upon them, and Adam was hid from Eve, and she from him, and they remained standing in prayer. Chapter 27. And then Satan, the hater of all good, saw how they continued in prayer, and how Yahweh communed with them, and comforted them, and how he had accepted their offering. And Satan made prohibition. He began with transforming his host. In his hands was a flashing fire, and they were in a great light. He then placed his throne near the mouth of the cave, because he could not enter into it by reason of their prayers. And he shed light into the cave until the cave glistened over Adam and Eve, while its host began to sing praises. And Satan did this in order that when Adam saw the light, he should think within himself that it was a heavenly light, and that Satan's hosts were angels, and that God sent them to watch over the cave and to give him light in the darkness. So that when Adam came out of the cave and saw them, Adam and Eve bowed to Satan, and that he would overcome Adam, whereby the second time humbling him before Yahweh. And then therefore Adam and Eve saw the light, facing it was real. They strengthened their hearts, yet they were trembling. Adam said to Eve, "Look at that great light, and those many songs of praise, and at the host standing outside that do not come in to us. Do not tell us what they say, or hence they would come, or what is the meaning of that light. What are these praises are? Therefore they have been sent hither, and why they do not come in? If they are from Yahweh, they would come in to us in the cave and would tell us their errand." And then Adam stood up and prayed unto Yahweh with a fervent heart and said, "O Yahweh, is there in the world another God than thou, who created the angels and filled them with light and sent them to keep us who would come with them? But lo, we see these hosts that stand at the mouth of the cave. They're in great light, and they sing loud praises. And if they are some other god than thou, tell me. And if they are sent to thee, inform me of the reason why thou hast sent them." No sooner than Adam said this, an angel from Yahweh appeared to him in the cave and said to him, "O Adam, fear not. This is Satan and his host. He wishes to deceive you, and he's as he deceived you first. For the first time he was hidden in a serpent, but this time he has come to you in solitude of an angel of light, in order that when you worship him, he might enthrall you in heavenly presence of God." Then the angel went from Adam and seized Satan at the opening of the cave and stripped him of the feat that he was assuming, and brought him into his own hideous form to Adam and Eve, who were afraid of him when they saw him. And the angel said to Adam, "This hideous form has been his ever since God made him fall from heaven. He cannot have come near you in it. Therefore did he transform himself into an angel of light." And then the angel drove away Satan and his host from Adam and Eve, said to him, "Fear not. God who created you will strengthen you." And the angel went from them. But Adam and Eve remained standing in the cave. No consolation came to them, and they were divided in their thoughts. And when it was morning, they prayed. They went out to seek the garden, for their hearts were towards it, and they could not console from having left it. Chapter 28. But when the wily Satan saw them, they were going to the garden, and he gathered together his host and came to the appearance upon a cloud, intending on deceiving them. But when Adam and Eve saw him thus in a vision, they thought they were angels of God, and came to to confront them about their having left the garden, or to bring them back again into it. And Adam spread his hands up to God, beseeching him to make him understand what they were. And Satan, the hater of all good, said to Adam, "Oh, Adam, I'm an angel of the great Yahweh, and behold, a host that surround me. And Yahweh has sent me and them to take thee and bring thee into the border of the garden northwards, to the shore of the clear sea, to bathe thee and Eve into it, and to raise you to your former gladness, and you return again into the garden." And these words spoken to the heart of Adam and Eve. And yet Yahweh's withheld his word from Adam and Eve and did not make him understand it at once, but waited to see his strength, whether he would be overcome as Eve was in the garden, or whether he would prevail. And then Satan called to Adam and Eve and said, "Behold, we go to the sea of water." And they began to go, and Adam and Eve followed them at some little distance. But when they came to the mountain to the north of the garden, the very high mountain, without any steps at the top of it, the devil drew near to Adam and Eve and made them go to the top, in reality, not in a vision, wishing he did throw them down and kill them, and to wipe off their name of the earth, so that this earth would remain to him and his host alone. Chapter 29. But when the merciful Yahweh saw that Satan wished to kill Adam and with his manifold devices, and saw that Adam was meek and without guile, God spoke unto Satan with a loud voice and cursed him. He and his host fled, and Adam and Eve remained standing at the top of the mountain. Hence he saw below them a wide world, high above which they were, but they saw none of the hosts which were among them before, and they wept, both Adam and Eve, before Yahweh, and begged for forgiveness. Then came the word from Yahweh to Adam, and said unto him, "Know thou that understand concerning this with Satan, that he spoke to deceive thee and thy seed after thee?" And Adam wept before Yahweh God, and begged and entreated him to give him something forth from the garden as a token to him wherein to be comforted. And God and Yahweh looked up to Adam's thoughts and sent the angel Michael as far as the sea reaches into India to take from hence the golden rod and bring them into Adam. Thus did Yahweh in his wisdom, in order that these golden rods, being with Adam in the cave, should sign forth a light in the night before him, and put an end to his fear in the darkness. And then the angel Michael went down by God's favor and took the golden rods as God had commanded him, and brought them to Yahweh. Chapter 30. And after these things, Yahweh commanded the angel of Gabriel to go down to the garden and say to the cherub who kept it, "Behold, Yahweh has commanded me to come into the garden and to take hence sweet-smelling incense and give it to Adam." And when the angel Gabriel went down by God's order to the garden and took the cherub and told the cherub as God had commanded him, and the cherub then said, "Well," and Gabriel went in and took the incense. And then Yahweh commanded his angel Raphael to go down into the garden and speak to the cherub about some myrrh and to give it to Adam. And the angel Raphael went down and told the cherub that Yahweh had commanded him, and the cherub said, "Well," and then Raphael went in and took the myrrh. And then the golden rods were from the Indian Sea, where there are precious stones, and the incense was from the eastern border of the garden, and the myrrh from the western border. Hence bitterness came upon Adam. And the angels brought these three things to Yahweh by the tree of life in the garden. And Yahweh said unto the angels, "Dip them into the spring of water, and then take them, and sprinkle their water over Adam and Eve, that they be a little comfort in their sorrow, and give them unto Adam and Eve. And the angels did as Yahweh had commanded them, and they gave all these things unto Adam and Eve at the top of the mountain upon which Satan had placed them when he sought to make an end of them. And when Adam saw the golden rods and the incense and the myrrh, he was rejoiced and wept, because he thought that the gold was a token of the kingdom which he had come, and the incense was a token of the bright light which had been taken from him, and that the myrrh was a token of sorrow in which he was. Chapter 31. And after these things Yahweh said unto Adam, Thou didst ask me something from the garden to be comforted within, and I have given these three tokens as a consolation unto thee, and thou trust in me and my covenant within thee, and I will make, and I will come and save thee, and the king shall bring me when in the flesh gold, incense, and myrrh, gold as a token of my kingdom, incense as a token of my divinity, and myrrh is a token of my suffering of thy death. But O Adam, put these by thee in the cave, and the gold, that it may shed light over thee by the night, and the incense, that thy smell is a sweet savor, and the myrrh will comfort thee in thy sorrow. And then Adam heard these words from Yahweh, and he worshipped before him. He and Eve worshipped him and gave him thanks because he had dealt mercifully with them. And Yahweh commanded the three angels, Michael, Gabriel, and Raphael, each to bring what he had brought and to give it to Adam. And they did so one by one. And Yahweh commanded Suriel and Cynthiel to bring up Adam and Eve and to bring them down from the top of the high mountain and to take them to the cave of treasures. And they laid the gold upon the south side of the cave, and the incense on the eastern side, and the myrrh on the western side. For the mouth of the cave was on the north side. And the angels then comforted Adam and Eve and departed. And the gold was 70 rods, and the incense was 12 pounds, and the myrrh was 3 pounds. These remained by Adam in the house of treasures, and therefore it was called of concealment. But other interpreters say it was called the cave of treasures, by reasons of the bodies of the righteous men that were in it. These three things did Yahweh give Adam on the third day after he had come out of the garden, in token of the 3 days Yahweh should remain in the heart of the earth. And these three things continued with Adam in the cave, gave him light by night, and by day they gave him a little relief from his sorrow. Chapter 32. And Adam and Eve remained in the cave of treasures until the seventh day. They neither ate of fruit of the earth nor drank water, for they were on a fast. And when it dawned on the eighth day, Adam said to Eve, O Eve, we prayed God to give us somewhat of the garden, and he sent his angels who brought us what we have deserved. But now arise, let us go to the sea of water we saw at first, and let us stand in it, praying that God will again be favorable to us and take us back to the garden, or give us something, for he will give us comfort in some other land than this in which we are in. Then Adam and Eve came out of the cave and went and stood in the border of the sea in which they had been thrown themselves. And Adam said to Eve, Come, go down into this place and come out of it until the end of the 30 days, and then I shall come to thee and pray to God with fervent heart and a sweet voice to forgive us. And I will go to another place and go down into it and do like thee. And then Eve went down into the water as Adam had commanded her. And Adam also went down into the water, and they stood praying and besought Yahweh to forgive them of their offense. and to restore them to their former state. And they stood thus praying until the end of the 5 and 30 days. Chapter 33. But Satan, the hater of all good, sought them in the cave, but found them not, although he searched diligently for them. He found them standing in the water praying, and thought to himself, Adam and Eve are thus standing in the water, beseeching God to forgive them of their trespasses, and to restore them to their former state, and take them from under my hand. But I will deceive them, so that they shall come out of the water, and not fulfill their vow. Then the hater of all good went not to Adam, but he went to Eve, and took the form of an angel, praising and rejoicing, and said to her, Peace be unto thee, be glad and rejoice. God is in favor of you, and he sent me to Adam. And I have brought him glad tidings and salvation of his being filled with the bright light as he was at first. And Adam, in his joy of his restoration, has sent me to thee, that thou come to me, in order that I can crown thee with light like him. And he said to me, Speak unto Eve, and if she does not come to thee, tell her of the sign, when we were on top of the mountain, how God sent his angels, who took us and brought us to the cave of treasures, and hid the gold on the southern side, and the incense on the eastern side, and the myrrh on the western side, and now come to him. And then Eve heard these words from him, and she rejoiced greatly, and thinking that Satan's appearance was real, she came out of the sea. And he went before, and she followed him until they came into Adam. And then Satan hid himself from her, and she saw him no more. She then came and stood before Adam, who was standing by the water, rejoicing of God's forgiveness. And she called him, and she turned up and found him there, and wept when he saw her, and smote upon his breast, and from the bitterness of his grief he sank into the water. But God looked upon him, and upon his misery, and upon him being out of breath, and about to breathe his last. And the word of Yahweh came up from heaven, and raised him up out of the water, and said to him, Go upon the high bank to Eve. And when he came up to Eve, he said to her, Who said to thee, Come hither? Then she told him discourse of the angel who had appeared to her and had given her sight. But Adam grieved and gave her to know that this was Satan. He then told her that they both returned to the cave. These things happened to them the second time, and they went down into the water 7 days after their coming out of the garden. And they fasted in the water 35 days altogether, 42 since they had left the garden. Chapter 34. And upon the morning of the 43rd day, they came out of the cave, sorrowful and weeping, and their bodies were lean, and they were parched from hunger and thirst, and from fasting and praying, and from their heavy sorrow on account of their transgressions. And they had come out of the cave, they went up to the mountain west of the garden, and they stood there praying, and besought Yahweh to grant them forgiveness of their sins. And after their prayers, Adam began to entreat Yahweh, O my Lord, my God, and my Creator, thou dost command the four elements to be gathered together, and they were gathered together by thy order. And then thou spreadest thy hand, and dost create me out of that element, and thou dust of the earth, and thou dost bring me into the garden at the third hour on the Friday, and dost inform me of it in the cave. And then at first I knew neither night or day, and I had bright nature, neither did the light in which I live ever leave me to know night or day. Then again, O Yahweh, in the third hour in which thou dost create me, thou broughtest me all beasts and lions, ostriches, fowls of the air, and all things that move in the earth, which thou hadst created at the first hour before me this Friday. And thou will was that I should name them all, one by one, with this suitable name. But thou givest me understanding and knowledge and pure heart and right mind before thee, that I should know them after thine own mind regarding the naming them. O God, thou madest them obedient to me, and dost order that not one of them break from thy sway according to thy commandment to the dominion of which thou givest me over them. But now they are all enraged from me. When I was at my third hour on Friday, which thou created me, dost command me concerning thee, which I was never to draw near nor to eat therefore. Thou sayest to me in the garden, when thou eatest of death, thou shalt die. And if thou hast punished me, as thou sittest in the death, thou shalt have died that very moment. Thereof, when thou commandest me regarding the tree, I was never to approach nor eat of. Eve was not with me. Thou hast not created her, neither hast thou yet taken her out of my side, nor she yet heard this order from thee. Then at the end of the third hour of that Friday, O Lord, thou didst cause a slumber and a sleep to come over me, and I slept and was overwhelmed with sleep. And then thou didst draw a rib out of my side and created it after my own solitude and image. And then I woke, and when I saw her, I knew she was. And I said, this is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh, hence she shall be called woman. And it was thine good will, O God, that thou bringest a slumber and a sleep over me, and thou dost forthwith bring Eve out of my sight until she was out, so that I did not see how she was made, neither could I witness. O Yahweh, how awful and great thou goodness and glory, and thy good will, O Lord, that madest me both the bodies and bright nature, and madest us two one, and thou gavest me thy grace, and dost fill me with praises of the Holy Spirit, that we shall be neither hungry nor thirsty, or know with sorrow, yet faintest of heart, and neither suffer fasting or weariness. But now, Lord, since we transgress thy commandment, break thy law, and has brought us into this strange land, and has caused suffering and faintness and hunger and thirst to come upon us. Now, therefore, O God, we pray, give us something to eat from the garden to satisfy this hunger within, and something where to quench our thirst. For behold, many days, O Yahweh, we have tasted nothing to drink, and nothing of our flesh is dried up, and our strength is wasted, and sleep is gone from our eyes from fainting and weeping. O Yahweh, we dare not gather aught to the fruit of the tree from fear of thee. For when we transgressed at the first, thou didst spare us, and didst not make us die. But now we ought in our hearts, if we eat a fruit of the trees without God's order, he will destroy us at this time, and will wipe us off the face of the earth. And if we drink of this water without God's order, he will make an end of the root as upon us at once. Now therefore, O Yahweh, that I am come to this place with Eve, we beg thou to give us of the fruit of the garden, that we may be satisfied with it. For we desire the fruit that is in the earth, and all else that we lack in it. Chapter 35. And then God looked again upon Adam and his weeping and groaning, and the word of God came to him and said, O Adam, when thou wast in my garden, thou knewest neither eating or drinking, neither faint nor suffering, neither leanness of the flesh nor changing, neither did sleep depart from thine eyes. But since thou transgress and comest into this strange land, all these trials have come upon thee. Chapter 36. Then Yahweh commanded the cherub, who keeps the gate of the garden, with the sword of fire in his hand, to take some of the fruit of the fig tree and to give it to Adam. And the cherub obeyed and commanded Yahweh God, and went into the garden, and brought two figs with two twigs, and each fig hanging on its leaf. And they were two of the trees among which Adam and Eve hid themselves when God went to walk into the garden. And the word of God came to Adam and Eve and said unto them, Adam, Adam, where art thou? And Adam answered, O God, I am, here I am. And when I heard the sound of thee and thy voice, I hid myself because I was naked. And the cherub took two figs and brought them to Adam and Eve, but they threw them to them from the altar, and they might not come to the cherub by reason of their flesh, that they could not come near the fire. And at first the angel trembled at the presence of Adam and were afraid of him. But now Adam trembled before the angels and were afraid of them. And Adam drew near and took one fig, and Eve came in turn and took the other. And they took them up to their hands, and they looked at them and knew they were from the trees among which they had hid themselves. Chapter 37. And Adam said to Eve, Seest thou not these figs and their leaves, which we covered ourselves when we were stripped of our bright nature? But now we know not what misery and suffering may come upon us from eating them. Now therefore, O Eve, let us restrain ourselves and not eat of them, thou and I, and let us ask Yahweh to give us the fruit of the tree of life. And thus did Adam and Eve restrain themselves and did not eat these figs. And Adam began to pray to Yahweh to beseech him to give him the tree of the fruit of life, saying, O Yahweh, when we transgress thy commandment at the sixth hour of Friday, we were stripped of the bright nature we had and did not commune with the garden after our transgressions more than 3 hours. But on the evening maddest, we came out of it. O Yahweh, we transgress against thee 1 hour, and all these trials and sorrows have come upon us till this day. And after these days together, 43rd day, do not redeem that 1 hour in which we transgress. O Yahweh, look upon us with an eye of pity, and do not requite us from according to our transgressions and commandment with these presents of the tree. O Yahweh, give us the fruit of the tree of life, that we may eat of it and live, and turn not to see sufferings of our trouble on this earth. For thou art Yahweh. And then we transgress thy commandment, and made us come out of the garden, and hid, and did us send the cherub to keep the tree of life, thus we should eat of it, and know nothing of the faintness after we transgress. But now, O Yahweh, behold, we have endured all these days, and have bore sufferings, and make these 43 days an equivalent of the 1 hour in which we transgressed. Chapter 38. After these things, the word of the Lord came unto Adam, and said unto him, O Adam, as the fruit of the tree of life of which thou ask, I will not give to thee. But when the 5,500 years are fulfilled, then will I give you the fruit of the tree of life, and thou shalt eat and live forever, thou and Eve, and the righteous seed. But these 43 days cannot make amends for thee. Hour which thou didst transgress my commandment. O Adam, I give thee to eat of the fig tree which thou didst hide thyself. Go and eat of it, thou and Eve. I will not deny thee thy request, neither will I disappoint thy hope. Therefore bear up unto the fulfillment of the covenant I made with thee. And God withdrew his word from Adam. Chapter 39. And then Adam returned to Eve and said to her, Arise, take a fig for thyself, and I will take the other, and let us go into our cave. And then Adam and Eve took each a fig and went toward the cave. The time was about the setting of the sun, and their thoughts made them long to eat of the fruit. And Adam said to Eve, I am afraid to eat this fig. I know not what may come of me from it. And Adam wept and stood praying before Yahweh, saying, Satisfy my hunger without my having to eat this fig, and after I have eaten it, what will profit me? And what shall I desire to ask of thee, O Yahweh, when it is gone? And he said, I am afraid to eat of it, for I know not what will befall of me because of it. Chapter 40. Then the word of the Lord came to Adam and said unto him, O Adam, why hast thou not this bread, neither this fasting, nor this care, ere this? And why hast thou not this fear before thou didst transgress? But when thou comest to dwell in this strange land, thy animal's body could not be on the earth without earthly food to strengthen it and to restore its power. And God withdrew his word from Adam. Chapter 41. And then Adam took the fig and laid it on the golden rods. Eve took her fig and put it upon the incense. And the weight of each fig was that of a watermelon, for the fruit of the garden was much larger than the fruit of this land. And Adam and Eve remained standing and fasting for the whole of that night until the morning dawned. And when the sun rose up, there at their prayers, Adam and Eve, after they had done praying, Eve came, let us go to the border of the garden and look south into the place hence the river flows. And it parted into four heads. And we will pray to Yahweh and ask him to give us the drink of water of life. And Yahweh has not fed us with the tree of life in order that we may not live. And we will therefore ask him to give us the water of life to quench our thirst rather than to drink of the water of this land. And then Eve heard these words from Adam, and she agreed. And they both rose and came to the southern border of the garden, upon the brink of the river, all the little distance of the garden. And they stood and prayed before Yahweh and asked him to look upon them this once, to forgive them and grant them their quest. And after this prayer from both of them, Adam began to pray with his voice before Yahweh, and he said, O Lord, when I was in the garden and saw the water that flowed from under the tree of life, my heart did not desire, neither did my body require any drink of it, neither did I know thirst, for I was living and above which I am now. So that in order to live, I did not require any food of life, neither did I drink of the water of life. But now, O God, I am dead. My flesh is parched with thirst. Give me the water of life that I may drink of it. O have mercy upon me, O Yahweh, and give me these plagues and trails and trials, and bring me into another land different from this, if that will not let me dwell in my garden. Chapter 42. And then came the word of Yahweh to Adam, and he said to him, O Adam, as to what thou art asking, bring me into the land where there is rest. It is not another land than this, but it is the kingdom of heaven alone where there is rest. But thou cannot make any entrance into that what is present, but only after my judgment is passed and fulfilled. But when I make thee go into the kingdom of heaven, thee and thy righteous seed, and I will give thee and them the rest that thou askest for at present. But if thou sayest, give me the water of life that I drink and live, I cannot be at this day. But on the day that I shall ascend into hell and break the gates of the brass and the bruises of the peace of the kingdom of iron, but I in mercy save thy soul and the souls of the righteous, and give them the rest of my garden, and shall be with the end of the world is come. And again, as regards to the water of life thou seekest, it is not to be granted to thee this day. But on the day that I shall shed my blood upon thy head in the land of Golgotha, for my blood shall be the water of life unto thee, and at that time, and not to thee alone, but to all of those of my seed who shall believe in me, that it be unto them for the rest and forever. And Yahweh said again unto Adam, O Adam, when thou wast in the garden, these trials did not come to thee. But since thou didst transgress my commandment, all these sufferings have come upon thee. Now always does the flesh require food and drink. Drink of them that water that flows by thee on the face of the earth. And then Yahweh withdrew his word from Adam. And Adam and Eve worshipped, and Yahweh, and returned from the river to the cave. And it was noonday. And then they drew near to the cave, and they saw the large fire by it. Chapter 43. And then Adam and Eve were afraid and stood still. And Adam said to Eve, "This is the fire by the cave. We do nothing to bring it about this fire. They never have bread to bake within, nor this to cook. As to this fire, they knew not the like, neither do we know what to call it. But never since Yahweh sent the cherub with a sword of fire that flashed and lightning in his hands, or the fear which we fell down like the corpse, have we seen the like. But now, O Eve, behold, this is the same fire that was in the cherub's hand, which Yahweh has sent to keep the cave in which we dwell. O Eve, it is because Yahweh is angry with us and will drive us from it. O Eve, we have again transgressed in his commandment in the cave, so he has sent us fire to burn us around it and to prevent us from going in. If it is really so, O Eve, where shall we dwell? And whither shall we flee from before the face of Yahweh? Since as regards to the garden, he will not let us abide in it, and he has deprived us of the good things thereof. But he has placed us in this cave in which we have bore darkness, trials, and hardships, until at last we found comfort within. But now that he has brought us into another land, who knows what may happen in it? And who knows that the darkness of that land may be far greater than the darkness of this land? Who knows what may happen in the land by the day or night? And who knows whether it be far or near, O Eve, where it will please God to put us, may be far from the garden, O Eve, or where God will prevent us from beholding him, because we have transgressed his commandment, and because we have made request to him at all times. O Eve, if God will bring us into the strange land other than this, in which we find consolation, it must be to put our souls to death, or to blot us out our name upon the face of the earth. O Eve, if we are further estranged from the garden and from God, where shall we find him again? Oh, ask him to give us gold, incense, and myrrh, and some fruit from the fig tree. Where shall we find him to comfort us in the second time? Where shall we find him that he may think of us as regards of the covenant he has made on our behalf? And then Adam said no more. And they kept looking, he and Eve, towards the cave, and at the fire that flared upon and around it. But the fire was really from Satan, for he had gathered trees and dry grass, and had carried and brought them to the cave, and had set fire to them, in order to consume the cave and what was in it. So what Adam and Eve should be left in sorrow, and he would be cut off their trust in God and make them deny him. But by the mercy of God, he could not burn the cave, for God sent angels around the cave to guard it for such a fire until they went in. And this fire lasted from noonday until the break of day. And this was the 45th day. Chapter 44. And then Adam and Eve were standing and looking at the fire and unable to come near the cave from their dread of the fire. And Satan kept on bringing trees and throwing them into the fire, until the flame thereof rose up on high and covered the whole cave, thinking, as he did in his own mind, to consume the cave with much fire. But the angel of Yahweh was guarding it, and yet he could not curse Satan, nor injure him by the word, because he had no authority over him. Neither did he take to doing so with words from his mouth. Therefore did the angel bear with him, without saying one bad word, until the word of Yahweh came, who said to Satan, "Go hence! Once before didst thou deceive my servants, and this time thou seekest to destroy them. Were it not for my mercy, I would have destroyed thee and thy host from off the earth. But I have had patience with thee until the end of the world." And then Satan fled from before Yahweh. But the fire went on burning around the cave like a coal of fire the whole day, which was the 46th day and Adam and Eve had spent since they came out of the garden. And when Adam and Eve saw that the heat of the fire had somewhat cooled down, they began to walk towards the cave to get into it as they were wont. But they could not by reason of the heat of the fire. And when they both took to weeping because of the fire that made separation between them and the cave, and that drew towards them, burning, and they were afraid. And then Adam said to Eve, "See this fire of which we have a portion in us, which formerly yielded to us, but now no longer does so. Now that we have transgressed and limited of creation and changed our condition, and our nature is altered, but the fire is not changed in this nature, nor altered from its creation, therefore has it now power over us, and we come near it, it scorches our flesh." Chapter 45. And when Adam rose and prayed unto Yahweh, saying, "See, this fire has made separation between us and the cave in which thou hast commanded us to dwell. But now, behold, we cannot go into it." And then Yahweh heard Adam and sent him his word and said, "O Adam, see this fire, how different the flame and the heat thereof are from the garden of the delights and the good things in it. When thou was under my control, all the creatures yielded to thee. But after thou hast transgressed my commandment, they all rose over thee." And again Yahweh said unto him, "See, O Adam, how Satan has exalted thee. He has deprived thee of the Godhead and of all the exalted state like unto me, and has not kept his word unto thee. But after all, is become thy foe. It is he who made his fire on which he meant to burn thee and Eve. O Adam, has he not kept his agreement with thee, not even one day, but has deprived thee of the glory that was on thee? When thou didst yield to his command, thinkest, O Adam, what he that he loved thee when he made this agreement with thee? Or that he loved thee and wished to rise thee on high? But no, Adam, he did not do all that out of love for thee, but he wished to make thee come out of light into darkness, and out of an exalted state to degradation, from glory to abasement, from joy to sorrow, and from rest to fasting and faint. And God said to Adam, "See this fire kindled by Satan around thy cave? See this wonder that surrounds thee, and know that it will encompass about both thee and thy seed. When thee hearken to his behest, that he will plague you with fire and that he shall go down into hell after you are dead, then shall you see the burning of his fire, that will thus be burning around you and your seed. There shall be no deliverance from it from you, but my coming. In like manner, as thou canst not now go into that cave, by reason of the great fire around it, not until my word shall come, that will make a way for thee on the day of my covenant is fulfilled. There is no way for thee at the present to come from hence to rest, not until my word comes, who is my word. Then he will make a way for thee, and thou shalt have rest. Then God called with his word to that fire that burned around the cave, that is part of himself asunder, until Adam that's gone through it. And then the fire parted itself by God's order, and a way was made for Adam, and God withdrew his word from Adam. Chapter 46. And then Adam and Eve began again to come into the cave. And when they came into the way between the fire, Satan blew unto the fire like a whirlwind, and made on Adam and Eve a burning coal fire, so that their bodies were sinned. And the coal fire scorched them. And from the burning of the fire, Adam and Eve cried aloud and said, "O Yahweh, save us. Leave us not to be consumed and plagued by this burning fire. Neither require us for having transgressed thy commandment." And then God looked upon their bodies on which Satan had cursed, had caused the fire to burn. And then Yahweh sent his angel that stayed the burning fire. But the wounds remain upon their bodies. And God said unto Adam, "See Satan's love for thee. Who pretended to give thee the Godhead and the greatness? And behold, he burns thee with fire, and seeks to destroy thee from off the face of the earth. And then look at me, O Adam. I created thee, and how many times I have delivered thee out of his hands. If not, would he not have destroyed thee?" And then God said unto Eve, "What is that he promised thee in the garden, saying that at the time ye shall eat of the tree, your eyes will be opened, and ye shall become like gods, knowing good and evil? And lo, he has burnt your bodies with fire, and has made you taste the taste of fire, for the taste of the garden, and has made you see the burning fire, and the evil thereof, and the power of it has over you. Your eyes have seen the good, and he is taking it from you. And in truth, he has opened your eyes, and you have seen the garden in which you were with me. And you have also seen the evil that has come upon you from Satan. But as to the Godhead, he cannot give it you, neither fulfill his speech to you. Nay, he was bitter against you and your seed, and it will come after you." God withdrew his word from them. Chapter 47. And then Adam and Eve came into the cave, yet trembling at the fire that had scorched their bodies. And so Adam said to Eve, "Lo, the fire has burnt our flesh in this world, but how will it be when we are dead? And Satan shall punish our souls. Is it not our deliverance long and far off, unless God come in mercy to us and fulfill his promise?" And then Adam and Eve passed into the cave, blessing themselves from coming unto it once more, for it was in their thoughts that they never should enter it, and they saw the fire around. But as the sun was setting, the fire was still burning and near Adam and Eve in the cave, and so they could not sleep in it. But the sun had set, and they went out of it. This was the 47th day after they came out of the garden. And Adam and Eve, when they came under the top of the hill by the garden to sleep, they were wont, and they stood and prayed Yahweh to forgive them of their sin when they fell asleep under the summit of the mountain. But Satan, the hater of all good, thought within himself, whereas Yahweh had promised salvation to Adam by covenant and that he would deliver him out of all the hardship that have befallen him, but was not promised me by covenant and will not deliver me out of my hardship, nay, since he has promised him that he should make him and his seed dwell in the kingdom in which I once was, I will kill Adam, and the earth shall be rid of him, and shall be left to me alone, so that when he is dead, he may not have any seed left to inherit the kingdom that shall remain mine, my own realm. And God will then be in want of me, and he will restore me to with my host. Chapter 48. And after this, Satan called to his host with all which came to him and said to him, O our Lord, what wilt thou do? And he said unto them, you know what this Adam, who God created out of the dust, is he has taken our kingdom. Come, let us gather together and kill him, or hurl a rock at him and at Eve, and crush them under it. Then Satan's hosts heard these words. They came to part of the mountain where Adam and Eve were asleep. And then Satan and his hosts took a huge rock, board, and even without blemish, looking within themselves. If there should be a hole in that rock, when it fell on them, the hole in the rock might come upon them, so they would escape and not die. And then he said to his host, take up this stone and throw it flat upon them, so that it would roll not from them or somewhere else. And then we have hurled it, flee and tarry not. And they did as he bid them. But as the rock fell down off the mountain upon Adam and Eve, Yahweh commanded it not to become a kind shed over them that did them no harm. And so it was by Yahweh's order. And when the rock fell, the whole earth quaked with it, and sudden from the size of the rock. And as it quaked and shook, Adam and Eve woke from sleep and found themselves under a rock like a shed. But they knew not how it was, for when they fell asleep, they were under a sky, not under a shed. And when they saw it, they were afraid. And Adam said to Eve, where was the mountain bent itself, and the earth quaked and shook on our account? And why has this rock spread itself over us like a tent? Does Yahweh intend to plague us and to shut us up in his prison? Or will he close the earth upon us? He was angry with us for having come out of the cave without his order, and our doing so of our own accord without counseling him. And when we left the cave and came to this place, and Eve said, if intended the earth to quake for our sake and this rock to form a tent over us because of our transgression, then woe be unto us. O Adam, for our punishment will be long. But arise and pray to Yahweh and let us know concerning this, and what this rock is, and what it spread over us is like a tent. And then Adam stood up and prayed before Yahweh to let him know about this strait. And Adam thus stood praying until morning. Chapter 49. And then the word of Yahweh came, O Adam, who consoled thee when thou camest out of the cave to come to this place? And Adam said unto Yahweh, O Yahweh, we come to this place because the heat of the fire that came upon us inside the cave. And then Yahweh God said to Adam, O Adam, thou darest the heat of the fire for one night, how will it be when thou dwellest in hell? Yet, O Adam, fear not, neither say in thy heart that I have spent this rock as an awning over thee to plague thee within. It came from Satan, who had punished thee, the Godhead and the majesty. It is he who threw down the rock to kill thee under it, and Eve with it, and thus to prevent you from living on the earth. But in the mercy of you, Just as the rock was falling down upon you, I commanded it to form an awning over you, and the rock under you to lure itself. And this sign, O Adam, it happened to me and my coming to the earth. Satan will rise up the people of the Jews to put me to death, and they will lie me in a rock, and seal a large stone upon me, and I shall remain in the rock 3 days and three nights. But on the third day I will rise again, and it shall be salvation unto thee, O Adam, and to thy seed. And believe in me, but O Adam, I will not bring thee from under this rock until the third day and three nights are past. And Yahweh threw him, and Yahweh withdrew his word from Adam. But Adam and Eve abode under the rock 3 days and three nights, as God told him. And Yahweh did so to them because they had left their cave and had come to this place without God's order. But after 3 days and three nights, God opened the rock and brought them out from under it, and their flesh was dried up, and their eyes and their hearts were trembled from weakness and sorrow. Chapter 50. And then Adam and Eve went forth and came into the cave of treasures, and they stood praying in it the whole day until evening. And this took place at the end of 50 days, after they had left the garden. And Adam and Eve rose again and prayed to God in the cave the whole of that night, and begged for mercy from him. And the day dawned, and Adam said to Eve, "Come, let us go and do some work for our bodies." And they went out of the cave and came to the north border of the garden, and they sought something to cover their bodies withal. But they found nothing, and they knew not how to do work, but their bodies were strained, and they were speechless from cold and heat. And Adam stood and asked Yahweh to show him something wherewith to cover their bodies. And then came the word of Yahweh and said to him, "O Adam, take Eve and come to see to the seashore where they fasted before. There you shall find skins of sheep. These flesh were devoured by lions, and these skins were left. And take them and make raiment for yourselves and clothe yourselves withal." Chapter 51. And then Adam heard these words. And when Adam heard these words of Yahweh, he took Eve and removed from the north end of the garden to the south of it by the river of the water where they once fasted. And as they were going the way, before they reached that place, Satan the wicked one had heard the word of Yahweh communing with Adam respecting his covering. It grieved him, and he hasted to the place where the sheepskins were, with entertaining by talking and throwing them into the sea, of the burning them in the fire, that Adam and Eve should not find them. But as he was about to take them, the word of Yahweh came from heaven and bound him by the side of these skins until Adam and Eve came near him. But as they neared him, they were afraid of him and his hideous look. And then came the word of Yahweh to Adam and Eve and said to them, "This is he who was hidden in the serpent, who deceived you and stripped you of the garment of light and the glory which you were. This is he who promised you majesty and divinity. Where then is the beauty that was in him? Where is his divinity? Where is his light? Where is the glory that rested on him? Now his figure is hideous. He is become abominable among angels. He has come to be called Satan. O Adam, wish to take from you this earthly garment of sheepskin to destroy it and not let you be covered with it. What then is his beauty that you should have followed him? And what have you gained by hearkening to him? See his evil works and then look at me. Look at your Creator and at the good deeds I do. See, I bound him until you came to show him, and behold his weakness, and no power is left in him." And God released him from his bonds. Chapter 52. After this, Adam and Eve said no more, but wept because Yahweh, on account of their creation, their own bodies that required an earthly covering. And then Adam said to Eve, O Eve, this is the skin of beasts of which we must be covered. But when we have put it on, behold, a token of death shall come upon us, inasmuch as the owners of these skins have died and have wasted away. So also shall we die and pass away. And then Adam and Eve took the skins and went back into the cave of treasures. And when in it they stood and prayed as they were in want. And they thought how they could have garments of these skins, and they have no skill for it. And then God sent them his angel to show them how to work it out. The angel said to Adam, Go forth and bring some palm thorns. And Adam went out and brought some, as the angels had commanded to him. And the angel began before them to work out the skins after the manner of one who prepares a shirt. And he took the thorns and stuck them into the skins before his eyes. And the angel began again stood up and prayed Yahweh that the thorns in the skins should be hidden, so as to be, as it were, sewn into one thread. And so it was by Yahweh's order that they become garments, and Adam and Eve and his clothes, he clothed them withal. For that time the nakedness of their bodies were covered from the sight of each other's eyes. And it happened at the end of the 51st day, that Adam and Eve's body were covered, and they stood and prayed and sought the mercy of Yahweh and forgiveness, and gave him thanks for what he had mercy on them and had covered their nakedness. And they ceased not from prayer the whole of the night. And when the morn dawned at the rising of the sun, they said their prayers after their custom, and then went out of the cave. And Adam said to Eve, Since we know not what there is in the westward of this cave, let us go forth and see it today. And when they came forth and went toward the eastern border.